And she always used to be happy to me. She would talk to me and she would talk to me. And Pacer excelled at that. Pacer knew where he came from. Pacer was a bright educated boy and Pacer had no ears. You couldn't even get Pacer put on a tie. Pacer did not have an MD complex. You didn't see Pacer walking around with a stethoscope around his shoulder to let people every know he was a doctor. This is the type of guy he was. But he was brilliant. Anybody who could, on a cow standing, and you could give it what they call a Peterson eye block, block the nerves going to the eye, and remove the eye while the cow is just standing unconcerned. Pacer had those types of skills. He was a very skillful veterinarian. And I mean, this country has lost a very, 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 very brilliant and dedicated servant. I wanted Pacer to come in with me in my private practice because I am now 83 and I can't continue much longer. And I was so surprised to see how Pacer was so turned off of veterinary medicine that he can't even finish it. And that really helped me. You know, and I know why, and I think everybody knows why. Pacer was a dedicated, humble servant. Everybody in the island knew Pacer. When you go into the field to feed the animals, everybody, Pacer, Pacer, Pacer. Some people will call him big-headed, but you know, not do that. But he had a joke for everybody. He was a big flirt, he told everyone he loved them and done this kind of thing. And that's just the type of guy he was. You know, and because of the easygoing way, the easy way he was going, many people didn't realize the importance and who this man was. You know? And this really, really sad to me. Pacer is a very dedicated, educated man. The whole of St. Peter's should be very extremely proud of Pacer, just like how they are proud of Dr. Jew. These are guys just a generation away from the same field, and look what they have come. And they need to be treated with dignity. It saddens me how Pacer left the veterinary profession. You know, compared to my situation, when I reached 55, I did not ask to continue. They asked me to continue until a vet was available. And when a vet became available, I told them, look, I'm leaving in October, the vet is here. And Dr. Jeremy Thomas recommended to then Minister of Agriculture that I stay on for 3 months to overlap with this person. And this I did. And at the end of those 3 months, the then Minister of Agriculture took me out to lunch with some dignitaries he had here and thanked me and so on. Pacer deserved that type of send-off. Pacer deserved that type of send-off. So just let you people know, you have lost a fantastic person, a great son, a friend, a complete professional, may his soul rest in eternal peace.
Eat it. I mean, these are the kind of thing he would say. I mean, I vexed, you know, but I had to laugh. But I vexed Carly Charles Quine. But what I didn't know is that Pacer say he ain't got no time to feed no child's cup and no spoon like me. He want to go play domino, so he just give the child a bottle and he gone out to play domino. But I thinking in my mind he crying because he ain't eat no food. And then Pacer find a joke that is so funny that would make you laugh. Everything was a joke for him. He had not a dull moment. Not a dull moment that Pacer had. We we argue and we make a lot of noise based upon any topic that joke. Because you know, we family, we see how you could stop there with all your stupidness. That's based. You can't go sleep with no sundown, with no stress in your head when it comes to Pierce. He must left you with something, right, Dominique? Right, Dominique? Anyone else wish to say anything? Don't wait until 2 o'clock and say, I want to. I don't tell Pierce all what I wanted to tell Pierce last month. It was last month. It was last month? When we had the family thing. Last month, I tell Pierce all I wanted to tell him. I did not know that was the last time that I was going to dance with Pierce, but I danced. I don't know who told me to dance because I can't dance. I can sing very well, but I cannot tune, so I would not even try to sing. You coming for the mic? Last time with our mommy, Newey. And for the toast, I changed it up and I said, you know what? I say people with toast. All of you come out, brothers and sisters, let's dance. And we dance and we dance and we dance. I didn't know that's the last time I'm going to be dancing. Agriculture, you ready? And we are going to welcome our agriculture group where Pierce has worked for a very long time. And they're going to give a tribute in song.
Good afternoon, church. I'd like to observe all the protocols previously established. My name is Janelle Kelly, Acting Director in the Department of Agriculture. Dr. Lesroy Henry was a staple in the agriculture sector, particularly the livestock subsector. He worked his way up through the ranks from veterinary assistant to veterinary officer to acting chief veterinary officer and finally department head as director in a career spanning some 30 plus years. Dr. Henry worked tirelessly in the field of veterinary medicine for many years, caring for animals both on farms and at homes, as you may well know. I could always count on him to advise on animal health matters, from the simple to the complex, and also tease me along the way about my severe love for white chocolate. I vividly remember Dr. Henry in his coveralls, standing over the case book, ticking off names and making calls to farmers, saying to make sure their animals were tied up for when he and the team got to their farm. Pacer, as he was popularly known, has left an indelible mark on the agriculture sector, cementing his contribution in the annals of history. He will be greatly missed and fondly remembered by his colleagues for his jovial spirit, hearty laugh, and mischievous smile. Our agriculture family, both St. Kitts and Nevis, wish to extend sincere condolences to his family, friends, and colleagues, and wishes him eternal rest. We hope that this tribute in song comforts you and all those gathered here today to celebrate his life in some small way.
Thank you. you lay down your life for love, someone could refer. There's a place for people like you. I've heard up there the streets are made of gold. And when you get there, there's a hand to down here.
Thank you very much. Agriculture. I have a urgent notice from the police for P4131. You're asked to remove your vehicle immediately. It's not a summons or anything. It's just that it was packed in a way that the concrete truck almost ran into it. P4131. And there's another vehicle parked right there. PB 1544, could you remove your vehicles, please, for safety? So don't think you're going to get a summons. It's for safety.
searching for that open door. To lose.
Tribute by so Ambassador C.G. Cliver.
Pleasant good afternoon, church. As a member of the St. Peter's community, also a former Minister of Agriculture, I wish to use this opportunity to extend my deepest sympathy to the family of the late Lesroy Pacer Henry. Growing up in St. Peter's, there were two young men who were very ambitious, and one of them was Pacer. But those two young men started at the St. Peter's Primary School, growing up there and in the community and going to school there. They decided that they were going to challenge each other. And during the period, they end up in the top classes in St. Peter's and then move on to the Bastia High School. They continue their challenge, and after school, the two of them became two teachers. After that, they were transferred to the Department of Agriculture. And as you're aware, Pacer became a doctor in veterinary medicine. However, the other person became the permanent secretary in the Ministry of Agriculture. Also was a live wire here in St. Peter's. He played games, For sure, he played cricket. Once I did organize some windball cricket, and he was a part of that. He also played dominoes, and he felt that he was the best. I want to say this afternoon that he has lived a good life, and I of us who had the opportunity to be around Pacer, let us use the opportunity and his memories to continue to remember him. May his soul rest in eternal peace.
Anybody know that only God can do? Oh, fix it for me. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Because, Lord, I have a problem that only you can solve. So, Lord, do it for me. Can y'all play that for me?
Thank you. Please stand for the reception of the body. With faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our brother Lesroy for our burial. Our brother was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Therefore, with confidence, pray to God, our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise him to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our brother Lesroy. We thank you for giving him to us, his family and friends, to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Jesus said, I am the resurrection. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die.
The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed.
Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me.
I am sure that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord.
If we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living.
We brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms.
Jesus said, blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Remain standing for the opening hymn, Does Jesus Care?
Thank you.
Please be seated for the tributes. First, we'll hear from Lesroy's son, Estevan. I hope I pronounce it properly. Then we'll hear from the Masters Cricket Association, followed by St. Peter's Wesleyan Church, and then the Eastern Benevolent Society. So first, Estevan, Masters Cricket Association, St. Peter's Wesley Holiness Church, and then the Eastern Benevolent Society. We have a change in order. We go straight to the Masters Cricket Association, then the St. Peter's Wesley Holiness Church.
Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. On behalf of the Liberal Arts Master Cricket Association, I bring greetings from Antigua, Anguilla, St. Thomas, St. Croix, St. Martin, Tortola, Nevis, and St. Kitts Cricket Masters. I first met Dr. Lesroy Pacer Henry officially in about 1987, where there was a cricket match at Warner Park, St. Christopher Cricket Club versus Police Cricket Club. Pacer came to the police dressing room and asked who are the fast bowlers for the team and stated, I am going to put a bat on them today, and left. I inquired from Luther Kelly, who was the captain for police, who is that guy? And in reply, they called him Pacer. Luther further stated, do not let him knock you for six, because the whole of St. Kitts will know about it. After the game, Pacer came back to the police dressing room and said, Rollins, you are a good bowler. Pacer and I became friends from that encounter. From time to time, I would go around the island with him, giving dogs shots and for different ailments. In 2002, Dr. Lesroy Pacer Henry joined the St. Cricket Masters as a player and opening batsman for the St. Masters cricket team, where we played St. Martin in Nevis and we won that game. The Masters cricket is a group of men 40 and over who play T20 cricket in a competition format yearly. For the past 2 years, we travel around the Leeward Islands playing cricket, namely in Antigua, Anguilla, St. Thomas, St. Croix, St. Martin, and Nevis over the Whit weekend. Pacer moved from player to vice president of the St. Cricket Masters in 2008 and became president of the St. Cricket Masters in 2018 until his passing in 2023. Pacer's major achievement as president was to win this prestigious tournament, which St. Kitts won in 2023 for the first time, which was played in St. Kitts with the finals at Warner Park, St. Kitts versus Antigua. The St. Cricket Masters wish to extend condolences to the entire Henry family, and may his soul rest in peace.
Good afternoon, Church. On behalf of the Wesleyan Holiness Church at Stapleton, we would like to extend our deepest condolences to the family, the Henrys family, to the Davis family, especially to our beloved Murray and Cinder. I want to assure you that, as the Word of God says, earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. And God, his everlasting arms, are there to uphold you and to encircle you during this time of sorrow. We are going to render this hymn, Pearly White City. We are aware of the fact that death is an appointment for everyone, and it behoves us to make sure that we are a part of the eternal home. So we will reflect on the vision that John saw when he saw the pearly white city. May God bless us all.
Oh. Eastern Benevolent Society, and then they found the Southern.
Good afternoon, church. My name is Theodore Brown, and I'm the chairman of the Eastern Benevolent Society Funeral Home. Death don't have no mercy in this land. Death will leave you standing and crying in this land. Grateful dead. Death don't have mercy. I knew Dr. Henry for over 25 years. He always regarded me as a friend and brother. We got even closer when I became the training officer at the Customs Department. I had to liaise with him at the Ministry of Agriculture. From that time onwards, we were like brothers. And please forgive me if I shed a tear or two at this point. On July 20th, 2023, the Eastern Benevolent Society Funeral Home Board member Dr. Lesroy Henry passed away. His death was sudden and shocked us all. We are heartbroken and his loss is deeply felt. When Lesroy joined the board of directors in 2017, we made a new friend who encouraged us to be bold and be brave. He would challenge our basic assumptions and pushed us to think harder and care harder for those who make the funeral home work. Lesroy was wise, kind, and compassionate, with an underlying bit of mischievousness that always kept us on our toes. Lesroy, though, wasn't just the guy who made faces when he disagreed with you, shared salty plums with lemons with you, and enjoyed a bastia before dinner. He was a well-respected veterinarian at the Department of Agriculture. He was a community man and always spoke highly of his community of St. Peter's. Yet, for us, Dr. Henry, the board member from St. Peter's, who always made you smile and who would light up when you're talking about all the animals he attended to or talking about his children. He was Lesroy, our friend and colleague, who always had a little bit of rascal twinkle behind his eyes. Earlier in the year, I asked Lesroy to supervise the roof project at the funeral home because I would be off island. He responded immediately. He reported to me on a daily basis. He was very trustworthy and dependable. On my return to St. Kitts, he asked me to meet him at the funeral home where he showed me the completed roof. He was also the doctor for my two dogs. I know my dogs will miss him dearly. Whenever he passed through Sandy Point, he would stop by and look at the dogs. I can recall that on Saturday, the 8th day of July, he came to look at them. Then he called me and said, "Mr. Brown, I'm coming back. I just get an urgent call. He didn't come back. And 2 weeks after, I received the shocking news of his passing. My wife and I extend deepest condolences to the entire family. Also, the board of directors of the Eastern Benevolent Society Funeral Home extend sympathy to the family. Adios, dear friend. You are deeply missed, but we know you are dancing around the sun. Well, everybody dancing in a ring around the sun. Nobody's finished. We ain't even begun. So take off your shoes, child, and take off your hat. Try on your wings and find out where you're at.
Good afternoon, everyone. Before we start, my little sister wants to say a poem on our behalf.
Goodbye to our dad. Our dad was always full of fun and laughter. He was an intelligent man. What he learned, he never forgets. I see a lot of my dad in me. We'll always remember that special smile, that caring heart, that warm embrace you always gave us. We'll miss you, Daddy. We will remember the good times and try not to be sad. But saying goodbye still hurts so bad. We miss you more than we can express. Our love for you will never grow less. In life, we love you dearly. In death, we do the same. It broke our heart to lose you, but we know you are with God in his heavenly place. You left us peaceful memories. Your love is still our guide. And though we cannot see you, you are always at our side. We will remember you each and every day. And if I need to talk to you, I will just sit down and pray. Lord, please take good care of our daddy. One day we'll be together again. Goodbye, we love you.
So how do I say goodbye to someone who's been with me for all my whole life? You gave me my name and the color of your eyes to see your face when I look in mine. So how do I say goodbye? No one could. You always saw the best in me. Right or wrong, you were always on my side. And I'm scared of what life is like, you'd be like. Saw the way you looked into our eyes. And I promise if you go, I would make sure we're alright. How do I say goodbye? Someone who's been with me for my whole life. The color of your eyes, when I see everyone's eyes. How do I say goodbye? How do I say goodbye?
Now hear from Melvin Henry, who will do the eulogy for us.
Good afternoon, church. The distinct privilege is mine to represent the family and you would read the eulogy of the late Dr. Lesroy Henry, a.k.a. Pacer, my brother. On July, approximately 8 a.m., I was on my way to work when my phone rang and my siblings were on the other line crying hysterically. They informed me that our brother had suddenly died. My heart sank, and I went into a state of denial and shock. And for the rest of that day, I sat quietly in tears and could not work at all. For the next 7 days, I questioned how this could happen. I just saw my brother 2 weeks ago, and he seemed healthy and strong. It did not make any sense at all. I turned to the Holy Bible for comfort, and the following scriptures came to me, to my head. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 57, verse 1 and 2, that the righteous perish, and no one takes it to heart. And the devout are taken away, and no one understands that the righteous are taken away to be spared from evil. And those who walk uprightly enter into peace. They find rest as they lie in death. And in Psalms chapter 23, verse 4, it says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. These Bible verses reminded me that God is in control and he is there for us, even when bad things happen to us. My brother's untimely death has caused me to reflect on his very beginning in this world and the memories that he had have left us. On December 25th, 1960, a baby boy was born, and he was named Lesroy Sylvester Henry. For my mother, Muriel E. Henry Davis, it would be her introduction to motherhood, with 7 of us following behind him. For Lesroy's father, Herman Huggins, who migrated to the U.S. Virgin Islands, Lesroy would be the 3rd of his 6 children. Lesroy was also affectionately known as Pacer. I don't recall why we started calling him Pacer at home. Some mention was made about another relative having the same name. Wherever he got that name, Lesroy answered anyone who called him Pacer. Rumor has it that Pacer is my mother's favorite child of 8 children. My mother worked tirelessly to provide for her son and all of other children. And those who cared for my brother would have encouraged my mother to send Lesroy off to St. Peter's Primary School since he was very talkative. At only 4 years old, my brother's social ability, personality was already quite apparent. As I can recall, our childhood was a lot of fun. We explored the mountains, eating mangoes and other fruits for our fuel to keep us going. The streets were our playground. We would play different types of games and sports, including cricket, football, dominoes, with the other children in the neighborhood. After completing high elementary school education, Lesroy attended Bastia Junior High School and then Bastia Senior High School. This is probably not a surprise to anyone here. Pacer excelled in school. He was brilliant and a hard worker, which led him to finish high school early. Fresh out of high school at the young age of 16, Pacer entered the teaching profession. First at the village school, which is now known as Dr. William Connor School. There he taught for many years, molding young minds. Then later, he was transferred to the Bastia Junior High School as a geography teacher. Lesroy taught for many more years. The exact number of years, I cannot recall. But I know he is very passionate about teaching. I can remember him telling me that he loved teaching so much that if the teaching profession paid much more better, he would have remained a teacher for life. During his teaching career, Lesroy learned about a diploma opportunity to study animal health science at Repaha in Guyana. In 1986, Lesroy left for Guyana. The program was a 2-year duration, and Lesroy studied hard and excelled at Repaha. But for those of you who know him well, those 2 years were not only spent entirely studying. He got involved with sports and his college community. His larger-than-life personality earned him the nickname Kitty, because he was from St. Kitts. Everyone knows Kitty is short for kitten. So Lesroy explained to them that he was too big to be called Kitty, so his peers started calling him Puss instead. In 1988, Lesroy returned home and began working at the Department of Agriculture. He worked with and reported to the chief veterinary officer at that time, Dr. Bernal Nisbet. Dr. Nisbet described Lesroy as hard worker, intelligent, and ambitious. Lesroy loved his work, going out in the field, treating and caring for animals and personal pets. He had found a new passion, one which he would dedicate the remaining part of his life to. His dedication to his profession was felt throughout the country. Recently, I met people who told me that my brother would take care of their animals even if they did not have the money to pay him. With an increased interest and a love for animal science and veterinary medicine, and a determination to broaden his horizon, Lesroy decided to further his education. And in 1996, with all of he had saved and the little money my mom gave him, Lesroy enrolled in the University of the West Indies St. Augustine campus in Trinidad to pursue a 5-year Doctor of Veterinary Medicine degree program. We all know the saying, old saying that says, you may know my glory, but you don't know my story. This would be fitting to describe his period while at the university. It was filled with good times and not the best of times. My brother would often tell the story that upon completing his fourth year of veterinary school, he had exhausted all his savings and with no money to complete his fifth year and final year. My brother came home to St. Kitts to work for the summer and to plan how he would get the money to finish veterinary school. But we all know when there is a will, there is always a way. My big brother, my educational role model, and at times my personal mentor, took a year away from university to work and by the end of the summer of 2021, he had garnered enough money to return to complete his final year in Trinidad. And in the year 2002, my brother earned his Doctor of Veterinary Medicine degree. From then on, he would be known by many as Dr. Lesroy, or Doc for short. Dr. Henry continued to show exemplary leadership, wearing many professional hats, such as doctor, teacher, lecturer, trainer, and mentor. And some of the many titles that my brother held, but not limited to these, are Animal Health Officer, Veterinary Officer, Chief Veterinary Officer, and Director of Agriculture of St. Kitts and Nevis. In addition, my brother was an adjunct professor at the Ross University of Veterinary Medicine. He provided hands-on training, experience, and instructions to students in their seventh semester of the studies. As stated by the St. Kitts and Nevis Times, Dr. Henry's unwavering passion for animals, his profound commitment to their well-being were evident in every facet of his work. As chief veterinary officer, he tirelessly strived to improve animal health standard and ensure the safety and well-being of both domestic and wildlife population. At Ross University, his expertise and nurturing spirit inspired countless aspiring veterinarians, molding them in compassion and skillful professional. Beyond his professional accomplishment, Dr. Henry will be remembered for his kindness, humility, willingness to mentor and support his peers. His absence is deeply felt, but his contribution to veterinary community will continue to inspire generations to come. End of quote. The Nevis page online state that Dr. Henry will be undoubtedly be remembered for his outstanding, unwavering commitment to the veterinary care, hearty laughter, remarkable work ethic, his friendly spirit, his invaluable contribution to agriculture sector, specifically livestock production, and the community he served will be greatly missed. Both publications offer their deepest sympathy to the family, friends, and loved ones for the late Dr. Henry. To date, many other professional organizations have offered their sympathies. This includes Eastern Benevolent Society, where he was a board member upon his passing, which you heard from today. Yes, my brother was very educated and accomplished. But if I ended his eulogy without speaking of just his professional accolades, I would have done him a disservice. He enjoyed life in many other areas. Lesroy was very athletic and an avid sportsman. He was well respected in the sports arena. In his eyes, my brother was the best at every sport he played, and he reminded us all of it, or anyone he played against from time to time. My brother played cricket and football at the national and community levels. Lesroy played cricket for St. Peter's cricket team for many years. I was very privileged to play with him on the same team before I migrated to the United States. I clearly recall one time St. Peter's cricket team was playing the police cricket team in the 1990s. My brother and I were batting together. Pacer had just hit a six the previous ball, and the fast bowler came in and bowled a bouncer, and my brother swung hard. The fielder on the boundary took the catch but fell over the boundary line, resulting in consecutive six. And at that very moment, Pacer shouted out, "Too hot to handle, too cold to hold." And everyone on the cricket field and in the audience began laughing. My brother's love for cricket saw him get involved in different management positions once he retired from playing, such as the president of the Master Cricket Association. I remember sending him a voice message at the end of May 2023, and I did not hear from him for a week and a half. Then he finally sent me a message saying that he was sorry for just getting back to me, and he informed me that he was very busy with a Leeward Islands cricket tournament that ended June 1st. Beside cricket, my brother played centre-back for Top Stars football team for many years. He was also a former member of the St. Peter's football team. He played the game with much joy and pride. Lesroy was also a very good sprinter and an avid domino player. And those who worked and knew him well would have heard him bragged about being the best in these sports too. And as he got older, he played a lot of dominoes. And anyone who knew him very well would know where to find him at the end of his workday. Yes, and some domino boards spending long hours playing day after day. My brother Kate and I come from a big family. We love him and he loves us all. He was not always available for family time, but you had better believe that he gave great advice on many different areas of life. And even though he spoke a lot, you can tell him something in confidence and he would not repeat it to anyone at all. And if you asked him for anything, he would find a way to give it to you, whatever you ask for, within reason. He was many times the mouthpiece of the family with his big, commanding, and confident voice. I would even dare to say that if he were here today, he would claim to be the best of everything in our big family. According to him, he was the best dresser, the best cook, the best big brother in the family, and I can go on and go on. He would say for the case that he was the best in the family at all. I remember when I was in high school, one morning he called me over and told me that he needed to give me a lesson in ironing because mommy did not show me how to iron. And he made me stand there as he ironed my school uniform for me. Just recently, at our mother's 80th birthday party in July 2023, Pierce and I were debating as to who was the better cook. And as you guessed it, Pierce insisted that he was the best chef and could probably open his own restaurant if he wanted to. While he did not visit my mother as often as she would like him to, Pierce loved his mother. You could see his pride and joy at my mother's recent birthday party and family reunion in July of this year. My brother would often be heard calling Ermentrude as he drove past her house whenever he was in Stapleton during her work day. And when he came to see her, personally, I think he did it just to get her worked up, and then my mother would just smile. My brother was a provider for his family. He leaves behind 7 children: Desroy, Istvan, Jamal, Javazni, Zayden, Zalika, and Zakaya. Yes, my brother loved all his children. I know this for a fact because when he spoke of his children, you could see the pride and joy in his eyes. He talked about all of the accomplishments and how well each one of them were doing. I know many of the children felt his love at different times throughout their lives. Just as my mother, my brother worked tirelessly to ensure that they were all provided for. My brother also loved his extended family. He really loved his nieces and nephews, and he would show much pride after talking about each one of them and during catch-up session. He was a mentor and an icon to many of them. My brother, a distinguished figure in the field of veterinary medicine and a well-known local personality in St. Kitts and Nevis, may have passed away, but he leaves behind a legacy that will be forever irk in all our hearts and anyone he touched. He was known to all of us in many different ways: the brother, the son, the father, the uncle, the grandfather, the cousin, the athlete, the sportsman, the mentor, the trainee, the civil servant, the teacher, and the doctor. But we come together today to celebrate his glorious life. And even though we feel immense sadness today, we can reflect on his truly remarkable life and thank God that we are all part of his abundant life. He lived a full life. He did it all. He did everything and anything he wanted to do. He worked hard. He furthered his education. He built properties. He bought vehicles. He traveled. He built relationships. He assisted others to envision and obtain their goals through the mentorship and guidance. He made people laugh with jokes. He was a happy person. I never ever remember or saw my brother in a fight all my life. He left a legacy that all of us should be proud of. His death should show us that he was not only our family hero and legend, he was also a national treasure. As we come together to celebrate my big brother's life and the legacy that he leaves behind, let us learn from his legacy. And I know he helped me learn the following 4 lessons. First one: whatever you do, do it with passion. Study hard, play hard, give it your all. Never be mediocre. Never stop learning and continue to improve yourself. Second, remember the community you came from. My brother was from St. Peter's. He became successful. He still stayed and worked in St. Peter's. Third, once you succeed, mentor and give back willingly. Share your knowledge. Share your experiences to those who need it. Help other young people overcome the barriers that there exist in their life. And last, but by no means least, the 4th lesson is that in all that you do, never forget God. What is the purpose of life if we live it for ourselves? And what is life if God is not part of it? What will it benefit us if we gain the whole world and lose our soul? As you rest, my brother, dear Lesroy, Dr. Lesroy Pacer Henry, we want you to know that we love you dearly. Thank you for all the lessons that you have taught us all. We will be forever be grateful to you for the life you lived. May your soul rest in eternal peace. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Please stand now for the prayer.
Let us pray. Almighty God, we remember before you today your servant Lesroy, and we pray that, having opened to him the gates of larger life, you will receive him more and more into your joyful service, that with all who have served you in the past, may share in the eternal victory of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated for the ministry of the word. The Old Testament lesson comes from the book of Job, chapter 19, verse 21 to 27. This will be done by Tracy Thompson.
Reading from the Word of God, written in the book of Job, chapter 19, verse 21 to 27. Have pity on me, have pity on me, O you, my friends, for the hand of God has touched me. Why do you, like God, pursue me, never satisfied with my flesh? Oh, that my words were written down, oh, that they were inscribed in a book. Oh, that an iron pen and with lead they were engraved on a rock forever. But I know that my Redeemer lives, and that at the last he will stand upon the earth, and after my skin has been thus destroyed, then in my flesh shall I see God, whom I shall see on my side, and mine eyes shall behold, and not another. My heart faints within me. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Remain seated for the Psalm 121, and we'll do the Psalm responsively. I will lift up my eyes to the hills. From where is my help to come? He will not let your foot be moved. And he who watches over you will not fall asleep. The Lord himself watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The Lord shall preserve you from all evil. It is he who shall keep you safe. Remain seated for the New Testament lesson taken from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13 to 18.
Good afternoon. The scripture reading is taken from 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, reading from verse 13 through to 18.
But we do not want you to be uninformed, brothers and sisters, about those who have died, so that you may not grieve as others do, who have no hope. So, since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring him and those who have died.
For this we have declared
you by the word of the Lord that we are alive,
who are left until the coming of the Lord,
but will by no means
precede those who have died. For the Lord himself, with a cry of command, with the angel's call, and with the sound of God's trumpet, will descend from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, together with them to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words.
Here in the scripture reading.
Be to God. We stand to sing the congregational hymn. Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. Seated. Let me first acknowledge the presence of our Prime Minister, the Honorable Dr. Terence Drew. Also, I see the Honorable Eric Eveling. I think I see Ambassador Kenny Douglas. And if there are any other government ministers or members of parliament, we are happy to have you. Also, I see a few clergy brothers in the congregation. I also acknowledge your presence. Let me also, on behalf of our church family, the parish of St. Peter, extend our deepest sympathies to the bereaved family. I believe by now all of us know that it's never easy to lose a loved one. Additionally, the pain that a mother has to, or a parent has to endure, having to watch the demise and bury their child, is far beyond anything that this world can give. And so we want to say a special words of comfort to his mother, his sisters, his children, and of course, the extended family. We also want to assure you of our prayerful support, but we are only human, and there's only so much we can do. And I encourage you to, as the words of Psalm 121 said, to lift your eyes up to the hill, put your trust in God, and depend on him. He will carry you through. And so for today's meditation, I wish to share with you a few words taken from the book of Proverbs, chapter 16 and verse 25. Sometimes there is a way that seems to be right, but in the end, it is the way to death. I pray that the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts may be acceptable in thy sight, O God, who art our strength and our Redeemer. Amen. One of the things I remembered about Pacer, or Lesroy, Dr. Lesroy, is that he always spoke loudly and with conviction. Some may even say that he felt he was always right. I think his brother alluded to that in the eulogy. Or he always knew best, especially when it came to dominoes, football, and sports in general. However, we know that our God is a great and loving God who never ever makes a mistake. And he always looks at our hearts, whereas human beings may look at outside appearances. God always looks at the heart, and he always does what is best. It may not be pleasing to us, we may not understand, we may not even agree, but God always does what is right and what is best to him. And so with confidence in God, we leave our friend, our brother, Lesroy, today in the hands of a merciful Father, knowing that God's way is always the best, and his thoughts are far above our own thoughts. Sometimes there's a way that seems right, or seems to be right, but in the end, it's the way to death. Sisters and brothers, have you ever gotten lost? Although someone told you everything and exactly where to go and how to get there? I don't know about you, but I am somewhat directionally challenged. And sometimes have a difficult time finding my way, even reading maps, even though I know where I want to end up. And it is sometimes, I sometimes get lost even going to a place that I've been before. Sometimes many times. And find myself having to stop and ask for directions. Oftentimes, even when I know the name, the place, and the number, I still get lost. But isn't this normally true of our spiritual life as well? When we try to figure out the way that God wants us to go, we need to stop and read the scripture. We need to stop and get directions, get our bearings right by reading God's scriptures and listening to him. If we don't, we are likely to end up lost. In unintended places, in unintended situations, and even unintended relationships. And since God's way is always the right way to go, if we are not following Jesus, then it means that we're walking on the wrong road. We need to stop if you're not following Jesus. We need to stop what we're doing. Repent, turn around, and turn to God so that he may forgive our sins. We need to put all our trust in him and depend on him to guide us in the way that he says is right. And yet, so many people are still lost because they think they know best. They think that their way is the best or the right way, and end up in dark places or end up in death and destruction. How foolish it is to try to face life on our own, to try to negotiate or navigate the difficulties and difficult roads that we have to walk. How foolish it is to reject God's plan of salvation because we think we know better than God. We often think and behave that our way is wiser and better than God's wisdom. My friends, every one of us needs what only God, what only Jesus can give. If we truly want to inherit eternal life and see God face to face in heaven, we must put our trust in Christ for the forgiveness of our sins and the grace which we need to fight this life. We need to be reconciled to God. Are you still trying to do things your own way? Are you still trying to do things in a way that is against God's revealed word? Those of us who want to fight life on our own, our lives would say, like, with all due respect to Frank Sinatra, I did it my way. But according to Proverbs 16 and verse 25, sometimes there's a way that seems to be right, but in the end, it's a way to death. On the other hand, when we follow God's way, if we are seeking to have that personal relationship with Christ, then our lives would say, I did it God's way. Not I did it my way, but I did it God's way. And Jesus led me all the way, and I followed where he led. You see, it's not about us. So often we get caught up because of our achievements and because of our positions. We think it's about us. But I need to remind you, sisters and brothers, it's all about God. God is the one who gives us everything we have. God is the one who allows us to achieve. God is the one who allows us to be here today. And he decides who he's going to take tomorrow. So I don't mean to burst your bubble, but it's not about you. It's not about me. It's all about God. My friends, need I remind you that there are many religions, many denominations, but only Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. And he proved it by dying on the cross and rising from the dead so that we can have eternal life. Many times we try to push up our chests and think, I'm a self-made man or woman. But it's God who made us, and we belong to his. Our life belongs to God. It's not our life to live and do what we please with it. But we should seek to live a life that is pleasing to God. Many times we think that we have it all figured out. And then life throws us a bouncer. You heard Pacer was a good cricketer. Life throws us a yorker. And we can't hit it for six. We can't even play it down. We are bowled out. But when we put our trust in God, we continue batting until He calls us home. Only Jesus can save us. Muhammad could not do it. Selassie could not do it. Brahman could not do it. But only Christ can. And He did. Are you still lost and searching for meaning to life? Searching for truth? Jesus is the answer. Jesus is the answer for the world today. Although many people may think that they know best, God always knows best, and His way is always right. He is the way, the truth, and the life. And no one can come to God except to Him. In Matthew's Gospel, chapter 7, we read that broad is the way that leads to destruction, and many are found in it. But narrow is the way that leads to eternal life, and few are found in it. Which way are you taking today? Whose side are you on? There can't be no middle ground. It must be God's way or Satan's way. If you're not for God, you are against Him. And so we must choose today which way we are going to follow. And when we choose, we must remember this, that there's a way that seems right to a man, but that way often ends up in death. But to all who believe on Christ's name, He gave power to become children of God. You and I must seek to be children of God in every sense of the word. We need to tell people that following their own ways, such as good works, following or obeying a set of rules, trying to be good enough on our own, will not get them into heaven. Not even which day you worship will get you into heaven. Not even which church you are a member of will get you into heaven. Not even church attendance can make it right with God. As important as these may be, the truth of the gospel message is that only having a personal relationship with Jesus Christ, that is what can get us into the kingdom of God. Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to Father except by me." My friends, salvation is achieved by Christ's atonement and not by our attainment or even our achievements. When Jesus said that He is the way, the truth, and the life, He clearly means that the way to eternal life, though unseen, is still secure as our faith and trust in Him. He has already prepared the way to eternal life. The only issue that still may be need to be resolved, the only issue that may still be unsettled, is our willingness to believe and to accept Him. And we can look forward to eternal life because Christ has promised it to all who believe. And we know that Jesus always fulfills His promises. All who believe in Him will receive power to be called His children and receive all the full benefits of being a true child of God. How good it is to know that when we depart this life, we go to a better place. We go to a place where Christ has prepared for us, and a place where Christ will be with us forever. In the book of Revelation, we're told that no more crying, no more pain, no more suffering. For God himself would wipe away every teardrop from our eyes. Which way are you taking today, my brothers and sisters? Is it the way to death? Or is it the way to everlasting life with Jesus Christ, our Lord? In case you're still asking, how can we know the way to God? Only through Jesus Christ. Only knowing him as Lord and Savior, obeying his commands, living for him, and allowing him to live in you. That is the way to eternal life. Trust Jesus for your present and to secure your future. Trust Jesus to take you all the way to God, the Father. Trust him to take you home and to welcome you into his heavenly kingdom. When Jesus says he's the only way to God, the Father, some people may argue that way is too narrow. How can there only be one way? Well, there is only one God. And he's always right. And if he tells us, our duty is not to question it, but to believe, to accept as true. Our duty is not to figure any other way out, as attractive as those may seem. Our duty is to accept whatever Jesus says as true and to commit our lives to him totally and unconditionally. So some people think that if Jesus is the only way, then that is too narrow. But in reality, it is wide enough for everybody to enter. It is up to us to choose to accept or to reject. Even though scripture often describes the world as being narrow, it is still broad enough for you, it's broad enough for Pesa, and it's broad enough for all of us. We must decide who we are going to serve. I pray that our answer will be like Joshua. As for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. As for me and my house, we will walk in the way that God will have us to go. So instead of worrying about how limited it sounds to have only one way to God, we should be saying, thank you, God, for providing the way and for showing us the sure way to get to you. And that way that leads to eternal life is sure and secure as anything that we could think about. Because we know that neither life nor death nor anything else in all creation can separate a true Christian from the love of God which is in Christ Jesus. And notice I said a true Christian, not those who said they're Christians or who may be playing Christians. Nothing can separate a true Christian from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Believing in Jesus is the only way to heaven, since he alone died for our sins. No human being could do what he did, and we couldn't do it for us. We must accept his free gift of salvation so that we can be made right with God. Living the Christian life may not always be easy. It will have its challenges. It may not be popular. It is often difficult. But it is the one true and sure way. Will you decide now to follow Jesus until he leads you home? As we give God thanks today for the life of Dr. Lesroy Sylvester Henry, someone who most of us knew as Pacer. And the first time I met him, I thought he was a very good fast bowler because his name was Pacer. So I thought he was a good fast bowler. Nevertheless, I knew him to be a very good vet. And he would have attended to many animals. He would have attended to many cases, many situations where people would have called and said that the animals were sick. But Pesa was only one of many vets. And he was only human. But there's only one God, the true and ever living God.
If we want eternal life, we do not get to choose who we want to, but to choose the one only wise God. When your animal is sick, you can call Dr. Nisbet. When Pacer was alive, you could call Pacer and other vets. But if you really and truly want eternal life with God, then you must call upon the Almighty and ever-living God. He is the only way that leads to eternal life. And remember this, there is a way that seems right unto humans, but it is often the way of death. Choose the right way. Choose God's way, for it is the one sure way to eternal life. Amen. And so as we continue in our worship, let us all stand, those of us who are able to, and we'll confess with confidence and hope. We confess the faith into which we were baptized as we say together the Apostles' Creed as printed in the order of service and displayed on the monitors. I believe in God, the Father, the Almighty, the Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Please be seated for the offertory hymn, "And Can It Be?" And if necessary, will your anchor hold?
and to hold. Please stand.
Will your anchor hold in the storms of life? When the clouds unfold their wings of strife, when the strong ties lift and the cables strain, will your anchor drift? Our firm remain. Father God, this afternoon we thank you for your love and for your mercy. And Father God, we also thank you for your immeasurable love. This afternoon we have come to pay our last respects to a community person, Dr. Lesroy Henry. And so Father God, we ask you to bless this money this afternoon. And we pray, oh God, that this money will be put to the use, your use, dear Father. Use to build up the kingdom of God. And so, Father God, bless us this afternoon as a congregation. We ask you to bless those who did not even have it to give. But nevertheless, Father God, you are in charge. Bless us once again, my dear people. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
Remain standing as we continue in prayer, as we remember our departed brother, who would have done much in terms of giving to his home village of St. Peter's and to our federation as a whole. You remember that he would have done all he could to make our pets and animals well. We pray that just as we would have called him, he would have called upon Jesus to make sure that his soul is well as well. Let us continue in prayer. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. We say together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Blessed be God, our Father, the creator and preserver of all life. Blessed be Jesus Christ, the Savior and Redeemer of humankind. Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the enabler and sustainer of those who seek for grace. The Lord be with you. Let us continue in prayer. Grant us, Lord, the wisdom and the grace to use aright the time that is left to us here on earth. Lead us to repent of our sins, the evil we have done, and the good we have failed to do. And strengthen us to follow the steps of your Son in the way that leads to the fullness of eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Father of all, by whose mercy and grace your saints remain in everlasting light and peace, we remember with thanksgiving those whom we love but see no longer. And we pray that in them your perfect will may be fulfilled. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Hear, Lord, the prayers of your people as we remember before you our brother, Lesroy Sylvester. And grant that we who confess your name on earth may with him be made perfect in the kingdom of your glory. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And so let us commend our brother, Lesroy Sylvester, to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Heavenly Father, by your mighty power, you have given us new life in Jesus Christ. We entrust Lesroy Sylvester to your merciful keeping. In the faith of Jesus Christ, your Son, O Lord, who died and rose again to save us, and is now alive and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, in glory forever and ever. Amen. Please bow your heads now for God's blessing. May the God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the everlasting covenant, make you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you and all those who you love and care for, this day and forevermore. Amen. As we make our way to the graveside, we sing the hymn, Victory in Jesus. Thank you.
for your mercy never fails. All my days I've been held from the moment that I wake up. Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. You are
young people love money, but they don't like work.
Yes, but we are guest letter, but now you are getting your lamps.
Calling for you.
Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me. I will never turn away anyone who believes in me.
You who raised Jesus Christ from the dead will also give your life to our mortal bodies.
My heart therefore is glad, and my spirit rejoices. My body also shall rest in hope. I heard a voice from heaven saying, write this, happy are the dead who die in the faith of Christ, henceforth says the Spirit, they may rest from their labors, for they take with them the record of their deeds.
Man born of a woman has but a short time to live. Like a flower, he blossoms and then withers. Like a shadow, he sleeps and then sleeps.
In the midst of life, we are in death. To whom can we turn for help? But to you, O Lord, who are justly angered by our sin.
Lord God, holy and mighty, holy and immortal, holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us from the bitter pains of the
day. You know the secrets of our hearts. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Forgive us our sins, and at the last hour, let us not fall away from you.
In sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life, through our Lord Jesus Christ, we commend to Almighty God our brother, Lesroy Sylvester Pacer, and we commit his body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust. And we beseech you in your infinite goodness to give us grace to live in your dear love and to die in your favor. That when your well-beloved son shall come again in judgment, both this our brother Lesroy Sylvester and we ourselves will be found acceptable in your sight. Grant this for the sake of your son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Grant, O Lord, to all who have believed the spirit of faith and courage, that they may have strength to meet the day to come with steadfast resolution, not sorrowing as those without hope, but in thankful remembrance of your great goodness and in the joyful expectation of eternal life with those they love. And this we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Almighty God, in whom still live the spirits of those who die in the Lord, and with whom the souls of the faithful are in joy and felicity, we give you heartfelt thanks for the good examples of all your servants who, having finished their course in faith, now find rest and refreshment. May we, all who have died faith of your holy name, of perfect fulfillment of this in your eternal and everlasting glory, to Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, raise us, we humbly pray, from the dead of sin to the life of righteousness, that when we depart this life, we may rest in him, and at the resurrection receive that blessing which your well-beloved Son shall then pronounce. Come, you blessed of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world. Grant this, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, O mediator and redeemer. Amen.
Rest eternal unto him, O Lord, and let light perpetual shine upon him. The Lord bless him. The Lord make his face to shine upon him and be gracious to him. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon him. And may he and all the faithful departed, the mercy of God, rest in peace and rise in glory. Amen.
Amen.
Now to the hymns at the graveside. And the first hymn at the graveside is Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound. Blessed Assurance, the first hymn at the graveside. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing that day.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine, oh what a foretaste of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of his spirit, washed in his blood. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine.
Yeah.
have in Jesus all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer.
Tell him step back. Waiting above and raising Yeah.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see.
I'm Steadfastness and patience, not sawing as though without hope.